In 1864, a sheriff was taken by vigilantes. He was the ringleader of a gang that had murdered over 100 people and stolen over 1,000 pounds worth of gold. Just before they hanged him, the sheriff told the vigilantes that within a 2-hour horse ride, he could take them to more than his own weight in gold. This is the story of Henry Plummer. If you like the video, don't forget to subscribe, like, leave comments. In 1863, gold was found in Alder Gulch, what is now Montana. There was tons of gold found in this area. It was one of the hot spots in America at the time. There was tons of gold. There were tons of prospectors that were moving into the area. They were mining gold in the mountains, pulling it out, shipping it out, and it was just a hot spot, and there were tons of people around. With all of this going on, there was also kind of chaos. And of course, with prospecting, there were people being robbed, you know, occasional murder here and there. But all of a sudden in 1863, these murders spiked. The robberies went up, the murders went up. No one knew exactly what was going on, but people had an idea that there was a gang. They called them the Road Agent Gang, and they were just spreading chaos. People were coming up dead, gold was being stolen, and somebody needed to do something about it. This gang was operating between the towns of Bannock and Virginia City, and they were operating out of a place called Rattlesnake Ranch. This gang was also huge. At one time, they had over 100 members, and by some accounts, even 150 members. The good thing about having 100 to 150 members in your gang is that you can be more widespread. You can get across to different areas that people are finding gold. You can steal more, and you can just generally get more gold. The problem with having 150 members is that people can't keep their mouth shut, or when they get caught, they are very quickly to roll over on the boss. Over the course of about 6 or 7 months, over 100 people were murdered, and over 1,000 pounds of gold worth, in today's money, about $28 million had been stolen. The locals were tired of the violence, they were tired of chaos running rampant around their area, and the sheriff was not finding anyone, they weren't doing anything about it, so they decided to start a vigilante committee. This vigilante committee just swept through, arresting anyone that was a suspect, interrogating them, finding out who their friends were, who was behind it, and they immediately started catching people. Initially, they caught 3 people. 2 of the people talked and they banished them from the area. The 3rd one didn't and they hanged him. Once they started arresting people, they just started falling like dominoes. They ended up arresting 100 people over the course of about 2 months. Once they had this many people in custody, people started naming the sheriff, Henry Plummer. So Henry Plummer was arrested along with 2 of his deputies. They began questioning him and he wouldn't talk until he realized that they were gonna hang him. They ended up taking him to the gallows that he had actually commissioned to be built as sheriff for hanging bad guys, and that's where his life was about to end. So he started begging for his life, pleading for his life, and trying to make a deal. He told the vigilante committee that within a 2-hour horse ride, he could take them to more than his own weight in gold. They didn't believe him or they didn't care. They didn't want to make any deals with him. They wrapped the noose around his neck and they hanged him. However, they did steal over 1,000 pounds worth of gold. And Henry Plummer, being the ringleader, most likely had most of this gold. He didn't spend it. He had it hidden away somewhere. He was the sheriff of Bannock. That's where they hanged him. And he said that it was within a 2-hour horse ride of where they were. So within a 2-hour horse ride, there should be a lot of gold somewhere in that area buried, and to this day there have been no reports of anyone ever finding that gold. If you enjoyed the story, don't forget to like, subscribe, leave comments. Thanks for watching.